Get ready to match the stars. Dick Gaudier, Brett Summer, Charles Nelson Wright, Marianne Mobley, Richard Dawson, and Betty White as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 76. And now, here's the star of Match Game 76, Gene Rodgers.
Dignity, you must my hair.
Yes.
This is our first trip to Disneyland.
You want to ring it? All right. Okay. Let's say hello to Denise Rose and Jody Dietzel.
How are you? You okay?
Uh-huh. Have my tape I picked up.
Denise is our current champ. She has won $1,200, right?
Yes, of course.
And I guess someone who's still a student, that must warm the cockles of your heart.
Sure does. And I'm married to a man that took the year off to be with our kids. So he's the house husband, so I'm the breadwinner.
Oh.
So it comes in handy.
It really does. Terrific. Yeah. That's a very neat husband. And where are we? We're in the middle of round one. You've had your first round question, and it was a hard one.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, then we'll have a hard one for
okay,
her in a moment
that's fair.
Or so. But right now, we've got this for you. Ready? When you are, CB. Here we go. Round one. Denise, this is yours. And we'll see how you do with it. The jeweler said that customer is really weird. I'll tell you. When I told him this watch cost 100 clams... he asked me if I had change for a blank. That's how weird the customer was. The customer was really weird. When I told him this watch cost 100 clams, he asked me if I had change for a blank.
Change for a blank.
Change for a blank.
I know there's a cute answer in
watch
there.
Watch cost 100 clams. Got change for a blank?
How do you spell?
Huh? Spelling doesn't count. Draws a picture. What else was I supposed to do, Ira? Anything else?
Well, we're just going to mention that August 19th.
August 19th.
Fort Worth Cabaret.
Oh, really? She's really getting around this year, huh?
Yep. With her handsome husband, Gary.
Sir. Oh, Gary.
There are nice people there, too.
What?
How much are your fudgesicles?
Sorry, you can't afford it.
Don't you let them say anything. I want you to wear that damn Sino tonight. Han.
The jeweler said that customer is really weird. When I told him this watch cost 100 clams, he asked me if I had change for a...
pearl.
A pearl. Change for a pearl. Maybe yes, maybe no. One never can tell.
Enthusiasm, right?
That's right. Eight applauds.
I said a change for an oyster.
An oyster. What do you say?
I no longer let myself be confused on the show about an, or a.
That's right.
I just said a oyster.
Right. What do you say?
You couldn't get a hot, there's only...
Now, children, you must stop this or you're going to your rooms separately.
It's come over me.
The doctor said it would happen since the war. I'm taking the pill.
Come on.
I was all right till I saw that uniform. There's only 50 clams in an oyster, but there's 250 in a lobster.
In a lobster. I tell you, I don't believe that this is happening to me. What do you say? Well, let me
well,
give it to you.
Well, if you don't believe that, you're sure not going to believe this.
I told him his watch cost 100 clams. He asked me if I had change for a blank. And she said pearl.
Uh-huh.
What do you say?
I heard what everybody said.
All right.
Well, now, isn't it clams and linguine?
Hey, linguine sauce? He asked me if I had change for a linguine sauce?
Now, that's weird.
Just think what you look
looks like. She doesn't have to be smart.
Be nice, folks. Right. Yeah. I could be home watering my roses.
Why aren't you?
Yes.
You should see what she puts on the roses.
Now, wait. Just take a second. Isn't it clams and linguine? Or linguine and clam salt?
Burns and Allen?
Avery and Schreiber, yes.
No.
Clams and linguine. I think you're right.
Yes.
Isn't it?
Well, remember the words of Charles. I said oyster.
Change for an oyster is the answer.
What date is this show on? This is June.
What time can you get?
June 17th.
Well, we shouldn't have oysters. There's no R in June.
That's the answer.
No R in linguine.
No, spaghetti with linguine sauce or clams.
No, not spaghetti and linguine sauce.
Clam sauce.
It's clams and linguine.
Clam.
Yeah, they're law firm.
Isn't it right, Ira?
That's it. All right, we're going to round two. I don't care what it is. Jody, what do you want?
Here. I'd like B again, please.
B, listen, let's get some of his score. Some. How about somebody scoring? Let's,
yeah.
Honey, listen, you and I.
Play.
You don't score in that jacket, you're never going to score.
As Freddie the fireman lay on the floor, all black and blue, he said, "Okay, who blanked the pole?"
Linguini!
No, not who linguinied the pole.
I think we're all ready up here.
Right. Okay. Oh, well, that was apparently without much thought required there. You ready for that, Jody? Okay. As Freddy the fireman lay on the floor, all black and blue, he says, "Okay, who blanked the pole?"
Who greased the pole?
Greased the pole. She said, "Who greased the pole?"
Greased. Oh, yeah. Okay.
She fell down. Greased, that's it. Oh, how neat. He's a good printer.
Do you know that thought never occurred to me?
Really? Why not? He's there lying there all black and blue. Obviously, he fell.
That's true. I didn't occur to me, but I said it anyway.
Oh, I hope this week ends soon.
You should put a little oil in the pan if you're going to make the clams and the linguine sauce.
Of course, yeah.
And you grease the pole.
Grease the pole. Jody, you've got three. Okay, who greased the pole? What do you say, Marianne? What do you say, Marianne?
I'm not even. For those of you who scoffed at linguine, please!
She learned the Palmer method. Did you know that nice, smooth... Did you study?
Jessie Wilshire, 8th grade, Brandon High School.
Really?
Said she couldn't teach us history till she taught us to write because she couldn't read any of our writing.
And that's how you...
And that's how it happened.
Isn't that interesting? All right, Richard.
I'm going to get grass stains on your white duck.
No, it is interesting.
It is fascinating.
Compared to the linguine story. Very interesting.
What have you got there?
Well, I was going to say, who moved the pole?
Who moved the pole?
That would have been funny.
Yeah.
It wouldn't be a match, would it?
No, it wouldn't be a match at all.
Oyster?
Grease. No, grease the pole. What do you got? We got five there. All right, it's Freddie the fireman laying on the floor all black. He said, okay, who greased the pole? What do you say to that?
Now, you see, Ted Knight has taught me never to even mention anything about poles. He gets very upset about this. Will you please not handle the merchandise? Thank you. Who greased the pole?
Who greased the pole? Very good. Now, listen, when we get back from this commercial, you got to go to work. You ready for that, Denise?
Of course.
All right. So, you, don't you forget to come back, too.
Latin
That's mandatory. Now, the champ has her work cut out for her. You've got to match all six celebrities to achieve a tie. Denise, listen carefully. This is it. Waldo has a strange way of showing emotion. When he gets mad, he doesn't blow his top, he blows his blank.
Is Waldo a person?
Yes, but he has a strange way of showing emotion. When he gets mad, he doesn't blow his top, he blows his blank.
isn't that sweet? I feel sorry for the poor little girl. I hate all those answers.
All right. Well,
that was it.
Whatever came to your mind first is what we always say.
I'm so nervous about it.
Well, you can be the villain.
Okay, here we go. Denise Rose. Waldo has a strange way of showing emotion. When he gets mad, he doesn't blow his top, he blows his blank.
Mind. That's all I can think of. I know.
What would you say?
No.
Nose? No. Did you think of that? You didn't think of that. She says, blows his mind. Got to match everybody, Denise. And what do you say?
I tried to follow a certain logic here, Gene, when I heard the question.
Naturally.
It seemed to me that if you say blow the top, the obvious alternative would be blow your bottom.
So, hey, so Jody wins the game. All the rest of you have. But Denise, I'm glad you're not leaving here empty-handed. You got $1,200, and that's going to help
so much,
you.
Son.
Good.
Bye.
Denise Rose,
thank
goodbye.
You.
What a sweet lady. Here's another one. Are you ready?
Yeah, I'm really nervous, though.
No, you're not nervous at all. Take a deep breath, and we'll plunge right into it. We polled a recent studio audience, Jody, and we got their best response to this. Hi-ho, blank. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 if you match it. If you match the second most frequently given response, you get $250. The third gets you $100. Now you're allowed to get a little help here from our celebrities.
Okay, how about Richard?
What did the Lone Ranger say? What was his name of his, Silver?
Silver, yes.
Hi, who's Silver?
It's Hi-Yo, but don't believe me.
What?
It's Hi-Yo,
was it?
So he says, hi-ho, Silver.
Betty?
Hi-ho, hi-ho, don't
forget. Okay.
And Brett.
Hi-ho, the witch is dead.
Hi-ho, the witch is dead.
Bingo. Oh, okay. Hi-ho, the Mario.
Hi-ho, the Mario.
I want the cameras. I wrote The Witch is Dead, and Carla Coppi stole it. And she died.
What do you say? So you got hi-ho the Mario, hi-ho Silver, and hi-ho, hi-ho, it's off to work we go.
Oh, boy.
Have you got any other ideas? Now think about it before you respond. It's up to you.
I'd say hi-ho the Mario.
What did they say, John? But, he said, hi-yo. The Lone Ranger said, hi-yo, Silver.
Excuse me.
He never said, hi-ho, Silver.
That's why he said, hi-yo, Silver.
Hi-yo, Silver!
What?
Yesterday, didn't we also have Bella? And they said, Bela Lugosi?
Right.
There's a great possibility they would say, hi-yo, Silver.
Oh! I'm absolutely sure there's that possibility. Anyway, she's chosen hi-ho the Mario. Let's find out if that upstairs is upstairs or downstairs.
No.
May we see the $100 response?
Do you remember the Lone Ranger? Do you remember his horse went crazy?
Yeah.
That's what he...
Hi-ho crackers!
Hi-ho crackers! Straighten up, you dumb horse!
Earl, you're not switching the cards, are you? Oh, he says, I only slide them. Earl the slider. All right, we want hi-ho the Mario. Let's see the $250 number. Hi-ho, hi-ho. That's Betty's answer there. It's off to work we go. All right, you think it's going to be Silver, don't you? Let's see it. Slide it. Silver.
You gotta believe me.
He may not always be right, but he's never wrong.
No, I'm as crazy as the people that vote. That's how I know.
Well, listen, Jody, you've got your $100, and you're gonna meet another player now. So let's welcome Cecil Fawcett.
Cecil.
Hi, Gene. How are you?
I'm very well. How are you, sir?
Oh, la-ti-da, I think.
If
I survive this, I'll be la-ti-da.
You're going to survive this, and you're going to have a good time here. We'll have some laughs, and you may win some money. Who knows?
Hopefully.
Where are you from?
Temple City. That's about 10 minutes from Arcadia, you know, where Santa Anita is.
Oh, yes, right, yeah. And what do you do for a living, Cecil?
I'm a contractor.
You're a contractor?
Or construction worker, I should say.
A construction worker.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Anything else you want to tell us about yourself?
Well, I have a lovely lady I've been married to for 30 years, 5 children and 12 grandchildren.
Uh-huh. You know how this goes? You got a chance to see this much?
Quite often, yes.
Quite often. Mm-hmm. So you know our routine here.
Right.
All right, we'll start the routine at some later date. Who's walking on my platform? I heard the thump of heavy feet here. Well, we'll investigate that while you investigate this. Hurry back! Ready, here we go. We've introduced Cecil. He's told a story of his life, and now we ask him to make a selection.
I'll try A.
A? All right, Cecil. Would you turn off Charles' light? Or is there a card in there, Charles?
Charles, take out the card.
Oh, would you turn off Charles?
Please. Yes, turn off Charles. All right. Thank you. For my next number.
And this is a man who stopped drinking.
As the warden led Rocco into the gas chamber, Rocco says,
"Warden, I got a last request. You mind if I bring along my blank?"
Questions like that and things about electric chairs and
just do your thing
and all that
and cool
just so, and all right. Oh, that's so good for my hot flash.
Oh, it is. You're too young to have a hot flash.
Of course I am.
Okay,
you better not buy me one more time.
As the warden led Rocco into the gas chamber, Cecil, Rocco said,
"Warden, I have a last request. You mind if I bring along my blank?"
How about teddy bear?
Teddy bear.
He said teddy bear.
I know he did. Cecil. I said bring along my mother-in-law.
Oh,
I thought that was a good idea.
Yes. What'd you say?
I resent questions about violence. You know that.
Okay, let's get all beyond that. Just show us the answer.
I want you to know he didn't want to go by himself. He said, "I'm going to take the wife and kids."
My wife and kids.
You talk about resenting violence? Really? Yes.
The answer I have.
You have the answer.
Yes. And the audience will tell you that.
Yes, that's true.
His lawyer.
Lawyer.
Yeah.
The guy who lost the case. Gotcha. All right, Cecil is looking for the answer. Teddy bear. "Warden, I have a last request. You mind if I bring along my teddy bear?" He says. What do you say?
Good morning, Marianne.
You scoffed at me for linguine, didn't you?
Yes, we have scoffed at your linguine.
Teddy bear!
This doesn't alter anything at all. It just means we're not going to scoff at Cecil as well.
We'll scoff at your linguine and his teddy bear.
Yeah.
What do you say?
Am I allowed to say, by the FCC ruling, am I allowed to say happy birthday to my friend Joel, who's a writer on the show, and it's his birthday today on the 17th? Am I allowed to say that?
No, they won't let us do that.
Oh, you all can't. Right.
No, direct communication.
I just thought I'd ask.
Yes, of course. Yes.
Happy birthday, Joe. Oh, I'm not.
Oh, so you to say that.
I understand.
Yeah,
a
can't
rule
say
is
that.
A rule.
Rule is a rule, yes.
Well, this guy hadn't taken the little woman out for such a long time.
Take
he
my wife.
To take his wife.
Take my wife, please, yeah. The warden. Do you mind if I bring along my teddy bear, according to Cecil?
I wish you'd let Dick do that, because Joel is a jewel. He really is.
Joel is a jewel. No, we can't do that.
Can't
no,
do that.
That's
no.
Impossible.
Well, he said, "Do you mind if I bring along my gas mask?"
Aha! A goodie! Yes, sirree, a goodie. Very well done, my dear. So, Cecil, that's one for you. And we'll see what you do in a moment or so, but right now we want to see about this. We are, friends. Let me say goodbye. Well, we're going to sea now, aren't we?
Oh.
And we're all going to have an ocean... Oh, I'm sorry, I'm upstaging you. I didn't mean to stand in front of your pretty face,
Jody,
or any other part of your body. Listen, we'll see you next time. We're in the middle of round one, 1-0. That's the way it is. And you were all just grand. You've made my day and my week, and I thank you. I'm in your debt. And I hope you will all come back. Some of them won't come back.
Who will be back?
Oh, you want to know? All right. Next time, these people will come back.
Dick Martin. Brett Summers. Charles Nelson Reilly. Julia Crowe. Richard Dawson. And Fanny Glass.
If you believe in fairies, applaud.
Yes, okay.
T. Never join us next time. Go on. We don't believe it.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 76. A Mark Fritz and Bill Todman production. Stay tuned for Tattletales next over most of the CBS stations.